ecology. You know, like ecology is something which people talk about, right? We always talk about ecology, we talk about our surroundings, and there's a lot of minor differences between ecology and environment. Something like between climate and weather. Like, you know, like when we say climate, what is climate? For example, Chennai has a particular climate, Delhi has a particular climate. Every city has a particular climate which is monitored over a period of time. Whereas weather is what is today. Weather is what is today. Like today it's raining, today it's cloudy, today it's sunny. This is weather. But climate is what happens throughout the period of time. So you can always say that Chennai, what is the climate of Chennai? Wow, hot, hotter, hottest. That's the way we try to express it. So when we talk about ecology, it's an entire holistic approach of the environment. Now, what does this mean? For example, if I take this word ecology, E-C-O-L-O-G-Y. Now, this term E-C-O is derived from the term O-I-K-O-S. This is a Greek word, echo. Now, though we, most of us, have this bad habit of pronouncing it as oikos, it is actually pronounced as echo. Something like, you know, if I want to send a message, for example, I want to send a message in Hindi, and but I'm going to use the script in English, and I want to say hum, I put it as a H-U-M. If I want to send it in Tamil, and if I want to send it as naan, I will put it as N-A-N. In the same way, this word, echo, is written in English as E-C-O. So what does this mean? The word echo means home. Home. Just like our own home, the entire universe is a home. And logy is study. Studying the home is ecology. You got my point? Yes. Studying the home is ecology. But if I evaluate the home, it becomes nomi. Because nomi means numbers. So that becomes economy. On one side, if you study the home, it is ecology. If I evaluate my home, it becomes economy. And unfortunately today, both of these fight with each other. Whether it's ecology or economy. And the world wants economy. And who suffers? Ecology. So our first step would be to understand what is ecology. Now, ecology, when I talk about ecology, the first word which comes to our mind as students is ecosystem. Because everything about the system which happens around us. And when I talk about ecosystem, the concept which many people tell is living, non-living. But let me go into some nuances of it. Now, in this ecosystem, if I take ecosystem as an ecosystem, the first component which is there is inorganic substances. Inorganic substances. Now, if I ask you, what are the inorganic substances? Come on, guess. Yeah, guess. Inorganic substances in the environment. No? I'll give you a clue. All elements and one molecule, all elements, forget the elements. One molecule, very important molecule. You and I cannot live without it. What's it? Yes, you guessed it right. Water. So all elements, like carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, everything, all the elements, and that one very important molecule, water. So that's the inorganic substances. And then we have the organic compounds. Organic compounds. Now, what are these organic compounds? Now, sometimes we tell, the amino acids, the fulvic acids, the humic acids, all these components are called as organic components. So these are the organic components. The third most important component is climate. How has climate to do with this? You know, normally you people, most of us, we travel hill stations, right? We start climbing the hill, some of these mountains. We have like Ootakaman, we have the Nilgiris, we have Yerkard, we have Kodaikanal, we have Simla, we have Darjeeling, we have anything like that, right? Hill stations. So as we climb higher and higher, don't we start feeling chill? So the vegetation varies, the organisms vary. So every organism gets adapted to that particular climate. So temperature, pressure, everything is related with altitude and the dimensions. Okay, so climate. The fourth most important component, we generally call them as producers. Now, who are the producers? Yeah, you told it. Yeah, I understood it. What are they? Green plants, right? So what do we call them as? They are the plants. They are the green plants. But what do we call them as scientifically? We call them as autotrophs. Autotrophs. Now, why should we call them as autotrophs? What does the meaning trough mean? Please understand, children, trough, T-R-O-P-H, is derived from the word trophos, T-R-O-P-H-O-S. And what is trophos? Yes, trophos is nutrition. Trophos means nutrition. If I prepare my own nutrition, it is autotroph. Clear? So next step is consumer. Consumer. Who are the consumers? You and I are all consumers. But there are some organisms, so we have to depend on other organisms. As consumers, we depend on other organisms. So autotrophs produce their own food. We derive our food by eating something else. Something else. Something else is called as heteros or second. That is, we come in the second line. So we are called as heterotrophs. Fine. Heterotrophs is perfectly okay. But we must also understand one thing. Within heterotrophs, those who eat only plants, what are they called as? You told me herbivores. But why should we call them as herbivores? Because they eat plants? No. You must understand the meaning. Now, if I tell about herbivores, H-E-R-B-I, V-O-R-E-S, V-O-R-E-S, vores, is derived from the word vori, V-O-R-Y. Vori is derived from the word devour, D-E-V-O-U-R, D-E-V-O-U-R. Now, what does devour mean? Devour means swallow. Devour means swallow. So what do I swallow? Herbs. So if I swallow herbs, I'm called as herbivore. Very good. Carnos, C-A-R-N-O-S. Carnos means flesh. Flesh, animal flesh. So if I swallow flesh, I'm a carnivore. The lion swallows the flesh. Right? The tiger swallows the flesh, the cheetah swallows the flesh, the fox swallows the flesh. So they are all carnivores. And then what do we call ourselves human beings? Yes, you guessed it right. Omnivores. Why should we call as omnivores? What does omni mean? You mean to say that it's a luxury omnibus, so we call it as omnivores? No. You know, how do we refer something, like for example, if you want to refer God or anything, how do people refer? Omnipresent. Omnipotent. Anywhere, everywhere. So you swallow anything, everything, you are called as a omnivore. Is that clear? So within consumers or the heterotrophs, we have herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. And the last very important group are the decomposers. They are very important for us. And they decompose. They decompose. They are very important because anything that's dead, that falls down, has to be converted, has to be decomposed. So they are important. So this group, like scientifically it is called as saprotrophs. Saprotrophs. Now what does that mean? Sapros. Just like I told you, auto, self. Hetero, something else. Sapros, decomposition, to decompose. So I derive my nutrition by decomposing something. Microorganisms, the bacteria, the fungi, they all consume the nutrients by decomposing something. So they are the saprotrophs. Is that clear? So six very important concepts in the ecosystem: inorganic substances, organic compounds, climate regime, producers, consumers, decomposers. What do we do, human beings? We put a line in between. And we call the top three as abiotic. And we call the last three as biotic. Bio. You study biology, right? What is biology? Logy is study. Bio is life. So studying life is biology. So bio means life. These are the biotic components, that is the living components. This is abiotic. A stands for absence. Absence of life, presence of life. It is only for our own satisfaction. You cannot separate. For example, what is air? Yes, air is non-living. Is it not? Air is non-living. What am I? Living. What is air? Non-living. What am I? Living. But if I remove the non-living air from my body, I become non-living. Water is non-living. I am living. Remove the water, non-living water from my body, I become non-living. You want to have some interesting question here. What did you have for breakfast? Come on, guess now. I had dosa for breakfast. Because I'm from Chennai, I had dosa for breakfast. What did you have? Chapati or idli? Let me presume that you had idli for breakfast, because idli is now universally available and declared as one of the healthiest breakfasts. So supposing you had idli for breakfast, tell me, what is the major component of idli? Is it rice or is it pulses or is it salt or is it water? What is the major component of idli? Yes, you guessed it right. Rice, right? So logically speaking, you had rice for breakfast. Now rice, does it have more amount of protein or more amount of carbohydrate or more amount of fat? Carbohydrate, very good. So you had logically carbohydrate for breakfast. Now what is carbohydrate made up of? Carbohydrate is made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Carbohydrate is made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So logically, what did you have for breakfast and I have for breakfast? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Where do you normally find carbon, hydrogen, oxygen? There, right? So what did you and I have for breakfast? Air. You and I had air for breakfast. Every one of us have air for breakfast. The same air we breathe is the same air we eat. All plants make use of this air and convert it into an end product. All plants do it. But some plants we eat. The plants we eat is called as food. So that's the beauty of this entire system. In this entire system, this is what we'll have to understand, that the concepts are all interrelated. That's the reason why the five components, air, water, soil, fire and ether, in Indian tradition are called as the Panchabhutas, or the five most important components of an ecosystem, and these interact together to make the whole ecosystem function and ecology alive.